Yeah. See this one. Allied angles. If you take any angle, that angle may be lying in the first quadrant, where first quadrant is ranging between 0 and 90 degrees, as you know. First quadrant is ranging between 0 and 90. So if you take first quadrant, I need not have to tell you that it lies between 0 and 90 because this is 0 degrees. And let me change the color. Let me change the color. This is 0 degrees. This is 90 degrees. I need not to tell you that. And this is 180 degrees. You can see this is already written here. Just see that. 0 degrees, 90 degrees. So first quadrant ranges between 0 and 90. Second range is between 90, 180. Third range is between 180, 270. And fourth range is between 270 and 360. This is 360. Okay. So according to the angle, you can say in which quadrant the angle is lying. 0 to 90 first, 90 to 180 second, 180 to 270 third, and 270 to 360 fourth, like that. Now, how this trigonometric ratio sine and cos behaves, what behaves means whether it is positive or negative in the quadrants is our concern here. We want to know that. But before that, some points you have to understand. First of all, in the previous class also, I have explained to you, cos A is nothing but horizontal component x. This is horizontal component. And sine A is nothing but a vertical component. It is nothing but y. And as you know, as you can see, this is a unit circle. Unit circle means whose radius is 1 unit. Wherever, whatever the line you take from the center, the length of this line in the circle is nothing but 1, because for a unit circle, radius is 1. Now, what is what I'd like to tell you here? First of all, wherever, whatever the quadrant we take, if you come across cos A, it is nothing but x component. If you come across sine A, it is nothing but y component. So y component is sine A, y component is vertical component, x component is horizontal component, x is nothing but cos A. So cos A is equal to x, x is equal to cos A. Remember like that, you'll understand why I'm saying this. Y is equal to sine A, y is equal to sine A. So vertical sine A, horizontal cos A. Remember that first. Now let us understand how this angle differs from the sine differs for or the whether the trigonometric ratio changes in different quadrants or not. That's what we are going to see now. See here. But before that, you have to understand one thing here. This line, I wrote it as, do you see what is this written here?
Mirror.
Mirror. So mirror means, you know, it is the image it takes. So if you take PXY, no, PXY, if you see your face in the mirror, what happens? Left side becomes right side and right side becomes left side, as you know that. Similarly, if you see this point PXY in this mirror, this line equation further you will be getting in straight lines. It is nothing but Y is equal to X. We call this line further as Y is equal to X. If you see the image of any point in this mirror, for the better understanding, I named this line as mirror. Then what happens now? Left becomes right, right becomes right. Left, that is x comma y becomes y comma x. Just understand that. Just understand that what is that I'm saying? PXY is there. If you see this point in the mirror, what is that you are getting? You are getting this point here. XY becomes YX. That's what you have to understand. Okay. Is it clear or not? You just tell me, Maurya.
Yes, sir.
That
Yes,
is
sir.
very
Clear, sir.
important. That is very important in this derivation. That is very important in this derivation. So XY becomes YX. Understand that. That means here X is horizontal component. Y is vertical component. Here, horizontal component has become Y. And vertical component has become x in this case. Okay. And understand that this angle we have taken to be, this angle we have taken to be angle A. This is angle A. When it is the mirror, what happens, you know, the same angle will be there. And you can see this angle is also A. And if you count the total, this is 90 minus this, this is total angle is 90 degrees. And if you take this angle, you know, it will be 90 minus A. This is 90, this angle A, and the total angle is 90. So this angle becomes 90 minus A. Why we are taking up this, you will understand now. Okay, now what happens? What happens if you take, I'll show you the moment through X component moves horizontally and Y component moves vertically. That's what I'm showing. Follow this carefully, please. Follow this carefully. First one, I'm showing you horizontal component. Just see that? Horizontal component. Just a moment. Now, see this. See that? I'm repeating that just to see how it is moving. Yeah, horizontal component. Did you see that? I'm repeating again. Yes, that is nothing but cos A. That is nothing but cos A. So similarly, let us see how Y moves. Y, see Y here. Repeating. Y. That's what. What is Y now? Vertical. What is X? Horizontal. What is X? Unmute yourself. Unmute.
Horizontal. X is horizontal.
Keep yourself unmute. Okay. So X is horizontal. Y is vertical. So that is what I wrote here. Cos A is equal to X and sin A is equal to Y. Correct? Now in the first quadrant, we have taken, if an angle A is there, X is cos A, Y is sin A. Let us move on to 90 minus A now. Just observe this. This line is nothing but 90 minus A, Maurya. How? Just say this. This is total. This point belongs to 90 minus A. This is angle A. This is angle A. This point belongs to 90 minus A. So now I'm taking up another triangle here. I'm taking up another triangle. Just see that carefully. Now, what happens if it is 90 minus A? Let us see that. See, that is, I'm repeating that. Yeah. So here, the horizontal component is Y. You have to see this point here. This is X is becoming Y and Y is becoming X. Now, let us see it again. Just see, horizontal is Y. Now, next, vertical is X. Vertical is X. I think you are not following that properly. What I'm saying, whatever the first coordinate is there, that is X. And whatever the second coordinate is there, that is Y. Whatever the first coordinate is there, that is horizontal. And whatever the second coordinate is there, that is vertical. That's what you have to understand. I think now it should be clear.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Now, so that is only for the mirror, right?
Yeah. Only for the mirror it happens. So what is that you have to understand here? Cos of 90 minus A. We are taking this angle here. Cos of 90 minus A. Cos means horizontal component. So cos 90 minus A horizontal component is Y here. Y. And sine of 90 minus A. Sine of 90 minus A is X here. X is what? Cos A. X is what? Cos A. So you have to understand this through these two. Okay. Y and X. So you observe it first. Cos of 90 minus A is sin A. Sin of 90 minus A is cos A. Okay. Now, just understand one more thing here. When you see y-axis as mirror now, let me show you that. Y-axis as mirror, then if you take the image of this point, what happens in the y-axis? Just observe it. This is negative x-axis, x becomes minus x, and y will be y only, positive y-axis. So xy image is minus xy. And what is the image of yx in y-axis? Just to see
minus
that.
Yx.
Minus yx. Y in the second quadrant minus plus. In the second quadrant, x is negative, y is positive. Y is positive. Do you understand positive. What I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Similarly, I remove that now. Now, similarly, what happens? If you see the mirror image in x-axis now, this is what I'm talking about. Minus yx is there. If you take its mirror image, it will be minus y minus x. Why? We have taken in the x-axis and this point enters in third quadrant. In third quadrant, both are negative. Similarly, if you take the mirror image of this minus xy in x-axis, if you take the image of minus xy in x-axis, it will become minus x minus y. Clear or not? Because in the third quadrant, both are negative. Similarly, coming to the next one. If you have any confusion, ask me, please.
Yes.
We have taken now y-axis as mirror. Then minus y minus x becomes plus y minus x. Why is it so? Plus y minus x because fourth quadrant.
X is equal to positive and y is negative.
Similarly, if you take this now, minus x minus y, this becomes x comma minus y. So what we did, we have taken a point xy and we are writing the same angle in different quadrants. Let me do one thing. I think because it is completely made up of, you may be getting confused. If I construct separately, I think you will get clear picture of this. Let me do that. One moment. Let me do that. I'll do that separately for you. Just a moment. Then it will be more clear if I do like that. See. Yeah. Just see this now. What I'm doing this separately for your better understanding. Just see this. Let me take a circle. A bigger circle I'll take. Okay? Now, let me draw the lines. This is x-axis. Where it starts from zero, and this is y-axis, and the upper side it is 90 degrees, and this is 180, this is 270, this is 360. I need not to explain you that, okay? Now, let me take a line, please. For your better understanding, what I'm doing, I'm taking up a line here, which is making an angle of A. Here, this angle is A. Understand that first. Now, what I'm doing, I'm telling you, further you will be getting this. This is called the angular bisector of the coordinate axis. I think you know what is an angular bisector. Angular bisector is the line which bisects the angle between two lines. That means this becomes 45, this becomes 45. Is it clear or not?
Yes, sir.
So when it is angular bisector, whatever the point is there on this line, if you take the image in this angular bisector, that will be reversed. What does it mean? If I take a point here, for example, P, X, Y. Okay, I'm writing this for you separately. Okay, now let me name this symbolically as theta, because theta is frequently used. Okay. So if I take the point xy, you tell me now, I'll draw the image line in the green color. Just see this. image line. This is the image line. See this clearly. Image line. Now, do you tell me what will be the coordinates of this point P dash? I'm naming it as P dash.
P y comma x.
That's right. This is what I want to make you to understand. Now, do you tell me, this angle here, this angle, this is theta. This is related to theta only. Now, this is related to, this is also theta. Why? It is angular bisector. No, it is angular bisector. Sir. Whatever theta is there here also, because it is 45, it is 45. Now, the same angle, because it is a mirror image, I say this is also theta. Do you accept this or not, Maurya?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. When I want to understand the total angle here made by, that is, I want to say you like this, if it is zero, this is x-axis, let me say, x-axis. Okay. Now, if I want to understand what is angle XOP dash, what is angle XOP dash? Can you tell me, please? XOP dash is 90 minus theta. If you accept this, I'll move forward. This is theta, this is also theta, and this total angle I'm talking about, this total angle that green line is making with this pink line. Green line making an angle of 90 minus theta with pink line. Do you accept this or not? You tell me first.
Yes, sir.
So, to construct the allied angles, what we are doing, we are introducing theta, 90 minus theta. Now, we are going for 90 plus theta, please. 90 plus theta. 90 plus theta, I'm showing that also in the green line. This one is 90 plus theta. Maurya, if you get any doubt, ask me, please.
Yes, sir, sure.
Come on, tell me, what is this angle and what is this point? I wrote it as P dash, no? And I'll be mentioning this as P double dash. Or to avoid any confusion, I'll name them like this. This is Q, let me say. And let me say this as some Q dash now, because we are going to take the, otherwise R you say, no problem. Come on, tell me now, what are the coordinates of R? Can you imagine? This is Y axis. This is the
minus y x.
Very good.
Minus y.
Very good. Tell me what is the angle related to R now in the circle? This is totally 90. This
90
is
90 plus theta.
That's good. Coming to the next line now. I'm drawing this blue line now. Blue line. So blue line. I'm going to draw like this. Do you tell me now the angle related to that R, I have already named it. Let me name it as S here. Yes. Do you tell me the coordinates of S?
Minus X comma Y.
Very good. Very good. Now, what is the angle related to this? This is totally 180, sorry. This is
180 plus. This is minus theta.
Very good. Very good. This is theta. So it is 180 minus theta. You're on the track. Now it is finished. You understand this clearly now. Now, let me name this T. Come on, tell me. What are the coordinates of T now?
Minus X comma minus Y.
Very good. Very good. Do you tell me what is the angle related to this?
180 plus theta.
Very good. Now, this is a mirror line anyway. LAST, let us change the PQRST. u, let me say. Come on, tell me the coordinates of u.
U is minus y, comma minus x.
Very good. What is the angle related to this? You have to go like this. This is theta.
270 minus theta.
Very good. Very good. We are creating all the angles now. These are called allied angles. Okay. 270 minus theta. Okay. Now, coming to this. PQRSTUW. Come on, tell me this. W coordinates, please.
W is...
Image only, image here.
So that's minus y comma minus 6.
Very nice. Y comma minus 6. Do you tell me the related angle here?
270 plus theta.
That's good. Now coming to this. You can answer your W. Let us avoid here. Y here, X here. And let me name it as Z. Come on, tell me. Z coordinates now.
Z is x comma minus y.
Good. Very good. It is done now. Now, what is the angle related to this?
360 minus theta.
Very good. Very good. 360 minus theta. So, generally, I don't explain this to the students. Generally, most of the faculty, they never explain this. They will simply give them as formula and they leave it and they ask the students to remember this. But I'm proving it for a better understanding, for the better analysis. Okay, see ya. Now you will say everything very, very faster and you need not have to by heart. Just to say this, just to say this. Now, what I'm doing, I'm taking up this one, vertical components in yellow color. Vertical components in yellow color. This is vertical component. This is vertical component. This is vertical component. And here also, this is vertical component. Of course, there is little construction problem. That is why they must coincide. They must coincide. And here also, this is vertical component. They must coincide. In fact, line little problem, that's it. Okay, now what is that? I said x is the horizontal component, and y is the vertical component.
Vertical.
So what is that you have to understand? X is equal to cos theta and y is equal to sine theta. Let me change the color so that you'll be better understanding that just a moment. Let me minimize this. It will be more clear now for you. Now, let me write that. Come on, tell me. Sine 90 minus theta, I'm writing first, Maurya, and after that, I'll write cos 90 minus theta in the first quadrant. I need not have to tell you sine 90 minus theta means this is the
cos theta.
That's good. That's good. Cos theta. Why it has become cos theta? Because sine 90 minus theta means vertical component. Here, vertical component is nothing but x here. But what is x here? Cos A. What is x here? Cos A. And x is equal to cos A and y is equal to sine A. This is what I said in the beginning and yesterday also we discussed this. And of course, here we use a theta. Let us change this as theta. X is equal to cos theta and y is equal to sine theta. This is a point you have to remember. Okay, now let me write this. Sine 90 minus theta. Here, this is related. Sine 90 minus theta is nothing but the vertical component, x. But vertical component is nothing but cos theta. So sine 90 minus theta is cos theta. Now cos 90 minus theta. is a horizontal component. Sine theta, that's it. Now, coming to this angle now. Come on, tell me. Sine of 90 plus theta. This one, no? Sine 90 plus theta, if you write, let me first write horizontal component so that it will not have any confusion. So horizontal component is nothing but cos. So cos of 90 plus theta. Cos of 90 plus theta, what is the related x coordinate here? Minus 5. This is 90 plus theta, no, Maurya?
Can't hear you.
You can't hear me?
Sir, I can't hear you.
Just a moment.
Yes, sir. Now I can hear, sir.
Yeah. So what is that I'm saying? Cos 90 plus theta I'm taking up. Cos 90 plus theta means horizontal component. What is horizontal component? Minus y there. But what is y?
Sine.
That's it. Next. Sine 90 plus theta.
Minus cos theta.
See properly and tell me.
It's minus cos theta.
What is sine, vertical or horizontal?
Sine is vertical.
Vertical. So what is vertical component here?
Oh, positive. Positive, positive.
So what positive is that cos you have to observe? What is that you have to observe? Sine is positive in the second quadrant and cos is negative in the second quadrant. Sine is positive in the first quadrant. Cos is also positive in the second quadrant. And thereby, sine by cos also becomes positive. Thereby, sine by cos also becomes positive. And rest of all trigonometric ratios becomes positive in the first quadrant. Coming to the second quadrant, just you observe, for cos it is negative, for sine it is positive. Observe this. Now, coming to horizontal component next, cos of 180 minus theta. And observe one more thing here. For 90, sine is changing to cos. For 90, cos is changing to sine. And for 90, tan changes to cot. And vice versa. That's nothing but allied angles. Sine becomes cos, cos becomes sine for 90 degrees. And here also for 90 degrees, sine is becoming cos, cos is becoming sine. For 180 minus theta, what happens? You tell me now. Cos of 180 minus theta, please. This one. Cos of 180 minus theta.
Horizontal minus cos theta.
Minus cos theta. That's good. For 180, is there any change in the trigonometric ratio? Cos is remaining cos only.
No.
Tell me what is sine of 180 minus theta?
Plus sine theta.
That's good. Any change for 180?
No.
180, sine is remaining sine only. Cos is remaining cos only.
Cos.
Is it clear, Maurya?
Yes, sir. Totally.
Yeah. Now say this. Oh, we are moving on to now. 180 plus theta, Maurya. 180 plus theta. Let me show you that. We will be writing anyway separately. Yeah. Now, what I'm asking you, sine of, we are writing first a horizontal component. You know, I'll write horizontal component only. What is it? Cos of 180 plus theta. Come on, tell me. Cos of 180 plus theta here. This one.
Minus cos theta.
Good. And I have written wrong here. This is minus x plus y.
Yes, sir, negative.
Minus x minus. Similarly, you tell me what is this one. Sine of 180 plus theta.
Negative sine theta.
That's good. Now you observe for 180, cos remains cos. For 180, sine remains sine. For 180, cos remains cos. For 180, sine remains sine. But for 90, it is changing sine to cos to sine. Correct or not? Coming to?
Yes, sir.
270 now. Coming to 270. Come on, tell me. Cos of 270 minus theta.
Minus sine theta.
That's good. Similarly, you tell me, just moment. This is minus x minus y. This is point is related to 180 plus theta, comma. So cos 270 minus theta, you said minus sine theta. Similarly, you tell me what is sine of 270 minus theta?
Minus cos theta.
That's good. So what is your observation here for 270? Also, it is changing cos to sine, sine to cos. Similarly, let us write cos of 270 plus theta. Coming to this point now, cos of 270 plus theta, horizontal component.
Sine theta.
Good. Sine of 270 plus theta.
Cos theta. Minus cos theta.
That's good. Now, what else is remaining? 360 minus theta is remaining.
360 minus theta.
Come on, tell me.
So there is a 360 plus theta?
Yes. It is there. This one is 360 plus theta. Again, one complete revolution we will get. 360 minus theta, you tell me, what is cos of 360 minus theta?
Cos 360 minus theta is cos theta. Sine 360 minus theta is minus sine theta.
That's good. Then what happens? 360 plus theta means again it enters here. It is 360 plus theta only.
So
whatever theta values are there, the same will be for 360 plus theta. For 360 plus theta and theta, we will take it as same. So what should be your observation, overall observation? All positive in the first quadrant, sine positive in the second quadrant, obviously it's reciprocal cosecant. And the third quadrant, either you see this, sine by cos, if you find out, minus minus gets cancelled. Here also, minus minus gets cancelled if you divide. Because for tan, it is minus by minus becomes positive. For tan, it becomes positive. And hence, in the third quadrant, tan is positive. Coming to fourth quadrant now, you can observe fourth quadrant means 270 plus theta. Just observe 270 plus theta. It is plus. 360 minus theta also, it is plus. So cos is positive in the fourth quadrant. So ASTC, that is why you have to observe that all silver teacups or add sugar to coffee like that. So all positive first quadrant, sine positive second quadrant, tan positive third quadrant, cos positive fourth quadrant. Okay. And what is your observation here? For 90 and 270, it changes. What is the change there? For 90 and this one 90, here also 90 is there. Here also 270 is there. 270. For 90 and 270, it is changing. For rest of them, it is not changing. What is that change here? Allied angle. Allied angle means sine to cos to sine. Tan to cot to tan, secant to cosecant to secant, like that. It is very simple. Allied means here you have yes, no. Add CO to yes, that becomes cos. Add CO to yes, that becomes cos. Similarly, tan is there. Tan, for example. What is first letter of tan? T. Add co to it. Co. Cot. So tan becomes cot. Similarly, secant is there. Secant. What is the first letter? First letter, yes. Add co to it. That will become cosecant. So for 90 and 270, it changes. Now let us summarize this. An important thing to be understood. Any doubt here up to this, Maurya?
No, sir.
I'm erasing this now.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now what we do, we will be now summarizing this. What does it mean by summarizing? Because to apply in the problems, we'll be doing this now. That's it. It is simple now. It is very clear for you. You will be telling me this easily. Let me write that. And some part of it, I'll give you as homework. And rest of them, I'm explaining now. Okay. Now, let me write that. Come on, tell me now. Sine of cos of 90 minus theta. Obviously, tan also I'm writing, but rest of the three you will be writing. I'm not writing. You'll take it as homework. Next is sine 90 plus theta. Next is cos 90 plus theta. Next is tan 90 plus theta. Okay. Now you tell me the next angle. We will write them at a stretch. Sine of
180 minus theta.
Correct. Next.
Cos of 180 minus theta.
Very good. Next.
Tan of 180 minus theta.
That's good. Let us now write the next one. You tell me. Sine of
180 plus theta.
Next.
Cos of 180 plus theta.
Next.
Tan of 180 plus theta.
Yeah. Coming to the next.
Sine of 270 minus theta.
Good. Next.
Cos of 270 minus theta.
Next.
Tan of 270 minus theta.
Next.
Sine of 270 plus theta.
Yes.
Cos of 270 plus theta.
Yes.
Tan of 270 plus theta.
Okay. And finally.
Sine of 360 minus theta.
And
cos of 360 minus theta, tan of 360 minus theta.
That's good. I like that. Now, let us take the values. Come on, tell me. Sine of 90 minus theta for 90 changes.
Changes, so cos theta.
Yes. For first quadrant, it is all positive. First of all, let us fill the signs. For second quadrant, sine is positive. You tell me, what about cos here?
Cos negative.
And tan also? Same. Negative, obviously. Plus by minus, minus. Similarly, for second quadrant, sine
negative.
Sine.
Wait, so it's third quadrant, right?
No, 180 minus theta, no?
Oh, yeah.
And cos 180 minus theta, second cos negative.
Negative.
And obviously, plus by minus, minus here. And coming to this.
Negative, now, negative.
It is negative, you're good. Next, it is minus. Minus by minus, it becomes plus. And coming to 270 minus theta, third quadrant, sine is negative. And cos is also negative.
Negative.
But tan is positive. And coming to this, 270 plus theta, fourth quadrant.
That's minus.
Cos is
plus.
Plus. And tan is obviously minus. How do you decide that? Minus by plus. Minus. Okay. Similarly, 360 minus theta, fourth quadrant, it is negative. Cos 360 minus theta, fourth quadrant, it is positive. Okay. Now, let us write. It is very easy to remember. Like what I'm saying here, you can understand for 90 changes, I said, we have written signs now. There's no problem at all now. We have written signs totally. Now tell me, for 90 changes, I said.
Cos theta.
Yes, cos. This one?
Sine theta.
This one?
Cot theta.
Yeah, that's good. And this one?
Sine. Wait, cot, cos.
This one?
Sine.
And here?
Cot.
Here?
Sine.
And this one?
Cos.
Because for 180, don't change.
Tan.
Coming to this?
Sine.
Good. Next?
Cos.
Good.
Tan.
Positive.
Yes, positive.
This one?
Cos.
Good.
Sign.
Next.
Cot.
Good. Division of these two, that's it. You need not to think about that. Coming to this.
Sign, I mean, cos.
Yes.
Sign.
Division of these two.
Cot.
Mine is already written. Coming to this.
Sign.
Coming to this.
Cos.
Division of these two, obviously.
Tan.
Tan. Tan 360 minus theta becomes minus tan theta.
Tan 3.
These are called allied angles. You must understand this. Okay. Now, after this, I think it's clear to you. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Clear.
Yeah. Now, what I do, I'll be telling you if more than one cycle is there. How do we understand this? More than one cycle. What does it mean by more than one cycle? 0 to 360 is one cycle. And the 360 to 720, another cycle. This is like this. See what happens now? This is first cycle. First cycle. 360. Now 360 to 720. Next 720 to 1080. Do you understand? Whatever is happening in the second cycle also, it is taking up second, third, fourth quadrants. And in the third cycle also, it is taking up first, second, third quadrants, fourth quadrants, like that. So it makes no difference there. It makes no difference. So we will be generalizing this. We will be generalizing this to all the cycles. Let us see that. Let us see that. How it happens. See, now you tell me. This is useful in simplifying the larger angles. Larger angles means big angles are given. How to simplify this? That's what I'm saying. Sine of n into 360 degrees plus theta is there, where n belongs to natural number. N is any integer, we can say. N is any integer. Okay. Now, let us understand. 360, n into 360 plus theta, that is n belongs to I, means it is 1 into 360, 2 into 360, 3 into 360, 4 into 360. Again, it enters into first quadrant, you know. So what happens in the first quadrant? You can neglect this n then. You can neglect this n. Then write it as 360 plus theta only. What is sine 360 plus theta, please? Sine theta.
Sine theta.
Correct? For example, if you have 360 minus or plus theta, then you tell me. I repeat that.
Mine. 360 yeah, minus theta, then it will become minus sine theta.
Very good. Very good. That means it becomes minus or plus. If I write like that, whether you understand it or not, you tell me, please. What is that I'm saying?
Sir, I understood.
Yeah. This is equal to, for minus, it is minus only, but for plus, it is plus. So for minus, correspondingly minus. And for plus, it is corresponding to plus. Now coming to next, cosine. Come on. Now I'll understand whether it is clear, the concept is clear to you or not. Minus or plus theta, I'm writing. Come on, tell me.
Same, minus or plus cos theta.
Repeat. Think and tell me. 360 minus theta, fourth quadrant. Cos is positive or negative?
Plus or minus cos theta.
No. 360 plus theta, what will it be first quadrant?
360 plus theta. Oh. Hmm. So then cos theta will remain plus cos throughout.
That's it. That's it. Good. Now divide it. N into 360. Minus or plus theta, divide this. What happens? Minus or plus tan theta. This we will be using further. This we will be using further in writing the bigger angles. I'll take an example and tell you like this. For example, you need sine 750 degrees value. Then what we do now? We will be writing it as the multiples of 360 plus 30. Now, what I'm saying, no, you can simply neglect this. Neglect two, and then take it as 360 only. Neglect it. Now, write the angle. What is your sine 360 plus theta? What is the answer?
Sine 30.
What is sine 30? 1/2. Okay. Similarly, tan 1050 is there, for example. Any angle, any higher angle. Then what I do now, I'll be writing it as in the multiples of 360, 3 into 360
plus 20.
1080 minus 30.
Minus,
no? 1080 minus 30. Now you tell me, what is that I said? You simply neglect this. What will it be then? San 360 minus theta. Which quadrant it is?
Tan 360 minus
fourth quadrant. Yeah, fourth is positive or negative?
Tan is positive. Negative.
Fourth quadrant. Fourth.
Negative.
For 360, will it be changing or not changing?
It will not change.
Not change. So minus tan 30. What is the value of minus tan 30, please? Minus 1/√3. This is how we work out. This is how we work out the problems. Okay? These are called allied angles. These are called allied angles. Now, we will see. These are very easy now. In your CBSE textbook, whatever the problems are given, they can be easily solved. They can be easily solved with this one. With this one. Let me open that. One moment. Very simple problems. Let me start this for today and I'll show you and then we will continue in the next session. No problem. Yeah. The exercise, I made a document here. Trigonometric CBSE. Yeah. This is 3.2. I made a document here. For this one, just let me show you that. This one, exercise 3.2. I'll introduce this, but you can finish it comfortably and you try this on your own. Cos x is equal to minus 1/2. X lies in which quadrant, please?
Third quadrant.
X lies in third quadrant means cos is negative. So what is the question here? Find the values of phi trigonometric functions. Okay. Now to avoid any confusion, just draw a triangle and keep that quadrant in mind and then work out. So what is that I'm doing? Now I'm constructing a triangle and I'm marking the angle here as X and cos X, you know, it is adjacent side by hypotenuse and thereby opposite side becomes 4 minus 1, 3 under root. Correct, no? No.
Yes, sir.
And don't forget that this X belongs to Q3. This is a highlighted point here. Q3 stands for quadrant.
Quadrant 3.
Now, let us write number 1. Sine X. Come on, tell me. Sine X is negative or positive in the third quadrant?
Negative.
Cos X, it is already given. Let me write tan X.
Tan is positive. Tan is positive.
Good. Cot X, obviously, is reciprocal. Secant X.
Negative.
And cosecant X.
Also negative.
Good. Now come on, tell me sine X from the triangle. After deciding the signs, you can straight away write the values. What is sine X now, please?
Sine is opposite by hypotenuse, √3/2.
Yes. Come to tan X.
Tan is 1/√3. Root 3.
Cot X?
Cot is 1/√3.
Reciprocal of this. Secant X?
Secant X is 2. Minus 2.
Yeah, just reciprocal of this. Okay, cosecant x.
Cosecant is 2 by root 3.
Minus 2 by root 3. Root. So he gave one trigonometric ratio. We wrote the rest of them. So whatever the angle it is, now we are able to write different trigonometric ratios in different quadrants. So this is the exercise, and it is very easy for you to solve. You finish this exercise by next session. Okay, exercise?
Yes, sir.
3.2. Okay. Can you do that?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I think it is very comfortable for you to finish this. Okay, Maurya?
Okay, sir.
Bye. Good night.
Bye, sir. Night, sir.